very, very massive promotion in America.
Well, if it's true, if it's true that wrestling is in the genes, then she certainly should have a massive advantage here. Ruby Brookside was an absolute mainstay of the UK scene.
Absolutely.
And is now a highly respected trainer for the likes of Finn Balor, Samoa Joe, Baron Corbin, Austin Aries. He's trained them all.
Yes.
And this is his daughter, and she's making her debut here in BWE.
So hopefully we can we get to see a fantastic match from her. As I said, this is her debut. And as we can see here, little Miss Roxxy is not happy with how she's
And also she's making her debut, but straight away she's effectively in the number one contenders match.
Yeah, absolutely. As we said, as it was stated earlier, whoever wins this match is going to face the winner of the Bombshells title match later, which is between Ruby Summers and Sunny Storm, and whoever wins that will face each other for the title at Smash-Con. As we said, it would be our first anniversary show.
So,
22nd of May at the Royal Armouries.
So today is quite a day for betting. It's the Grand National today later on. So let's focus on this match and who's your money on in this match.
Absolutely, you've got to keep an eye on little Miss Roxxy because she's a bit devious. She will use the rope. She will use the rope. She will do some underhanded tactics. However, don't take anything away from Xia. She does know how to wrestle.
Well, she's already proved there with the tilt a whirl on the ropes to get out of the hammerlock, how athletic she is. Clearly, both these girls very, very athletic. Not an inch of body fat on either of them.
No.
They take their craft very, very seriously. But I just think it is Xia's debut, but I just wonder about Roxxy because she has made such an impact here. Surely the next destination on her journey is the new Bombshells champion. I just feel like it's in her destiny to be there. You know, her cohorts are the tag team champions. Imagine if she got the belt, and of course the Primate is the champion. They'd have all the gold.
Well, I was going to just you've just hit a point where I was going to bring up. Roxxy wants that title belt because that means the faction she's part of, which includes the tag champion Dragon Dragon and Primate, who is the current BWE champion. That would be fantastic for all of them holding the gold. However, how fantastic would it be for Brookside to win the match and then be able to, on her debut, which would be then her second match, face the champion, whoever it is, at the first anniversary show. How fantastic would that be?
Absolutely, it's been a massive event. We are expecting an amazing crowd at Smash-Con. So could you imagine these girls, both relatively new to the industry, making an impact? But hang on a minute, this number one contenders match has gone wild here. It's gone all around the arena. We're on the stage here.
And we're now, now coming in front of us.
A bit of a chase going on here, but they've got to be aware of the count out.
Yeah.
Got a little bit of a chase going on here,
and
Roxy's back in the ring. That breaks the count,
which means if she gets in there and she works straight over there, she knows how to work her opponent and look at the ring. She knows how to work it. Yeah, absolutely.
She basically loves Xia in there, I think, and that might be coming from Xia's maybe a slight naivety on her part, but these two are very matched up as well. They're not the biggest girls, they're not the tallest of girls, so it'll be interesting to see them in a match against either Tony Storm or Ruby Summers, who would have the size advantage against each other, though, extremely well matched up.
But for me, if I was a Brookside, I would sit there and think to myself, right, yes, I've not got the wrestling background. Yes, I've got wrestling in my blood, but I'm relatively new on the scene, and a lot of people are now using me up and down the UK circuit, which is brilliant for her. Get some exposure. How fantastic would it be to be relatively new on the UK circuit to get a title around her waist?
Well,
so
absolutely.
That's what she's going to build from.
And also, it would make her synonymous with the BWE as well, because it would be her first real major title, and what an impact she would make. Now, we mustn't get carried away. We've got a certain champion called Ruby Summers, and a number one contender, Tony Storm, to take into account.
Which, of course, worked all over Europe and all over the UK.
Well, you could argue that this match is the biggest match of either of these two girls' career. Today, one of them will be going to SmashCon, a huge event, to challenge for the championship. That's absolutely massive. And this has been a little bit of a game of chess so far. And I think both girls have been quite cagey with the other. However, Roxy is asserting a certain amount of dominance now, and that's her slight experience advantage maybe showing.
Yeah, absolutely. Two suplexes off the back. Fantastically done. And she hits the pin twice and only gets a two count.
Notice how tight the cover was there as well. She actually hooked both times. No nonchalant, no foot on chest, nothing along those lines. No. That's how much it means to these two girls.
And this is where we start to see it. She works her up. However, obviously, if you're new to wrestling, you have got to the count of five before you are effectively disqualified. So, yes, it looks bad, but she has that, she can use that count of five to her advantage.
Oh, that's not correct.
Brilliantly, so I apologise. Brilliantly hit by Zaya there. It's double knee to the almost like a code breaker.
It was effectively a code breaker to the face.
Yeah, brilliantly done. And she's working with, now she's working Roxy to the second turnbuckle.
Well, she's introduced her to two turnbuckles so far. We're going to get no, rake of the eye,
oh,
stops that.
And this is where I was saying before that she will use anything she can to gain momentum.
Well, hang on, he seems to be upset that she was going.
No, she shouldn't be using the sushi.
Going to a referee club, Anderson there. Referring to the jacket as an illegal weapon. Absolutely correct, it's a foreign object, should not be used.
Absolutely.
Referee Craig Anderson making the point there of why he'd removed that. And also now, she's almost brought some armaments into the ring with her. She's got a scarf from around the boot. She's got a coat in there with these items to potentially choke her opponent with.
As you were saying there before, the referee come up to me and see, explaining that she shouldn't be using the jacket. But I feel that even though we were unable to see it, the crowd acknowledged that I believe Roxy may have been doing something that the referee couldn't have seen.
Well, that was interesting, though, now, because she went for a toe-to-wheel head scissors. She didn't get all of it, and Roxy felt quite awkward there. And so, hey, the referee just checking there.
Zaya was able to get a two count, but only a two count.
She thought she had a three count, and the referee just went over just to check on Roxy and just to make sure she was all right. That toe-to-wheel didn't quite go the 360 degrees, but it did some damage.
In the world of wrestling, no matter who they are, you always want to hope that they're safe. And I hope there's no long-lasting effect to neck there.
Always a very dangerous move to go from a toe-to-wheel head scissors and hit full-on. Can usually mean the end of a match.
Yeah.
Both girls did extremely well to carry on after that.
Yeah,
the fatigue is setting in now, though.
But we can see that Roxy is moving around, so obviously, as you said, there's no long-lasting effect from that. And she's now just been reversed by Brookside into the turnbuckle, who is now just catapulting her into the other side of the turnbuckle. Oh, what a vicious boot to the middle.
Straight boot to the middle, sent Roxy flying down. And let's not forget. Let's not forget where Zaya's from. She's from Liverpool. They are scrappers. They know how to fight and they are resilient and they're not going to give up. And she's now getting the crowd behind her. Okay. That boot to the chest though really hurt Roxy. You can tell her still clutching her stomach.
And as we've just seen there, we just saw Zaya trying to get a three count, only a two count, but she tried again. Oh, she misses with a three-kick.
I think she might be out. I think she's out. She is. What a debut victory!
Brookside!
What a fantastic debut!
What a debut!